Hello everybody and welcome once again to Mechanism 110. Now, I was going to do plastics today, but there's something else I need to do, and that's to sort out these trees. They're taking too much time. Well, before I go and do those trees, have a quick look over here. I've done some little farm, set up some farms now, so we have a reasonable sized wheat field, very small beetroot field, some carrots and some potatoes, and they're all being farmed by progressive automation. And I set up some very simple automation on those just using some hoppers. What they really need are hoes, and they're all wood. This side's got hoes on it, and then on the other side we have put some, well, I have anyway, some pellets. So these are basically all these pellets are, if you've not seen that before, is to take a few of these, and doesn't matter whether it's coal or it's charcoal, and you can simply right click that, and then you can take the pellet and you can put the pellet into the machine like this, just like shift click it and into that hopper, and then it comes, gets fed into here. So these are now full of pellets and full of wooden hoes for a while anyway, to live for it. It takes quite a reasonable amount of time on these. They don't disappear too quickly. And I've basically done that on all of these machines. Here we've got some potatoes here and hoes, and on the other side pellets, and the same with all of them. But today I want to sort out this mess. So I've done some work in preparation. I've basically moved the ladders down here and made a little passage, and I dug this down one more layer and I made it out, opened it out. So the first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to come around to each of these. This is basically the input for the axis. Now the axis have run out of power at the moment, so let's just give the axis some power. You see, no more pellets in there. So what we'll do is we'll simply make some pellets for these, plenty of pellets, and put those into here for the time being, and fill up each one of these progressive automation crafters. There we go, that will do fine. And now we should see some axes coming out of here. There we go, one axe. And then that axe will then go around and be fed into one of these machines. Which one that's going into? A little bit of this one here will be coming in. Now the next thing I want to do after that is to add a way for two things. One, to get power in, and one to get wood out, or wooden saplings really. So the first thing we're going to do is to take the configurator here, make sure that it's set for items. So if you press E and you can highlight it. So at the moment it states wrench. So if I do shift M on this until it goes to configurator items, what I can then do is each of the center sections of the pipe, like here, if I shift right click on that, it changes its color. So in this case I'm going to make this dark green. In fact, the ones which are actually important are really the end, not the end pieces, but the middle. See, that's actually blue. And the same here, so I've done it twice. It's just getting reaching its problem. So as you see, once it gets coloured, it disconnects. Like that. And really what I want to do, I'm going to have to do all of these pipes. You'll see why in a minute. So let's just quickly right click on each of these sections. Maybe I could have even done some of this to start with. So this is getting a bit more difficult up here, but we can do it, I think. Let's push. It's getting the middle section to the hard bit, that one, and it should be in the corner here. There it is. There we go. So now I need to click that. Oops, I've got the wrong colour, and I've got aqua. So I'm going to have to cycle all the way through all of these colours until I get back to dark green, like that, and the same with this one. This one after dark blue, good. And the same with this one. So now they're all coloured, and you'll see why, because I need to basically run a set of output pipes beside these. And I don't want them connecting. Unfortunately, or the default, not unfortunately, is none. None will connect to any colour. Like this. One in the middle. And one at the end. The end ones are the difficult ones, of course. There, I think. You know, when you get it disconnects, there you go, like that. And the same with this one. Right, so they're nicely coloured. I might have to do these as well. That's not too difficult, though. And coming around here. See, it's quite clever the way that works. What I'm going to also want to do is to power these with fuel or with electricity, basically energy, RF, I think it is. I need to use that one there. There we go. So now these are all, I think, on the green channel. So what I want to do now is I want to go and get some more mechanism parts, which I've got prepared, fortunately. So I need some basic logistic transport is fine. We don't need it too fast. So I'm now going to drag these down from the middle section here, which is going to become the output. So the first thing I need to do is make sure that the PA, progressive automation wrench to PA wrench, is in output mode. There we go. And I'm going to right click the bottom of these, so it's output. And I'm going to put them the pipes on here like this. I have to shift right click, of course. And I see they connect. And what I want to do is I want to run those parallel but outside, like this. And the thing I would like to do this is to color these. And I've chosen, whilst I chose a green for the first one, because it's just then it's one click here and they just disconnect. So we can disconnect all of those and they won't join to these other pipes. So I've basically got to do that for all of these machines. So let's get on with doing that. So right click, I don't do shift right click. I did that last time, of course it disconnects. A bit confusing in a way. Let's see. And we want to bring it outside this pipe. So now we need to simply color this one. I'm just wondering if I should move my things around in my hotbar. Like that. So let's bring all of these down. In fact, what I'll probably do is I'll bring everything across first of all, let it all connect up, and then go and color it. It's probably easier. Now change the output. This first of all, change it to output mode. Get pipes onto it. And in fact, I'm going to also, before I do this, just so I can reach the thing, and sometimes it's difficult to reach it. I'll shift right click in the middle sections here. And you see they all start to split up. And now for the last one. So you can run pipes quite closely. It's a bit of a faff trick setting them all up, but you get there in the end. That one and this one, and change its color. Okay, what I will do is I will move stuff around a bit. I don't need the boat, but I do need the mechanical pipes. Did I change this to output mode? I don't think I did. Let's do that. Okay, good. And down we come with this one. And the last thing I want to do is I would like to put onto these, hit onto this side, I want to put cables, the universal cables. So let's get these out of the way as well. There we go. I should have enough. The reason I want to do this is I want to run power. And it's probably easier to set it up now than to do it later on. So let's just simply right click on that. That's actually connected. Didn't expect it to do that. Have I got the right item? No, I haven't. I've got mechanical cables. Okay, we just quickly break that. That flew off somewhere. Let's just jump up and pick it up. And then try again. So this time I want the universal cable. Now it shouldn't connect because we've got nothing for it to connect to. And we're going to do exactly the same thing with the cables. Go around the back, but I've always got to do the torches, of course, so it's too high now. And these don't connect, as you can see. So I do need the torches in place, otherwise there will be mobs spawning in here. Now obviously I've got to knock this piece of wood out of the way. When I was actually setting up my farm, first of all, let's pick it up. When I was setting up my farm, first of all, I got lots of spruce wood, and all of a sudden I stopped cutting spruce trees. And the reason for that was, I discovered, as I put a chest on top, and when there was a chest on top of the progressive automation, the spruce trees simply did not grow. It was very strange. Let's put that torch over here. So we're okay for torches, and let's carry on with this, because I basically don't want mobs dropping down here. That's a part of the reason for this as well. Not that I think they're going to spawn around here, but there's always a chance I've just done the same thing again, haven't I? Yes, pop up and get that. Right, there we go. Don't want to lose those things. They're not that expensive, but they're also not that cheap, because you've got to make steel for them, haven't you? And the plan is, I'm going to use biofuel to fuel these. The biofuel will come from will come from the saplings or the apples. Maybe the saplings would be good. So now what I've got to do, let's go around these and reconfigure these to be the dark green side. Oh, that's blue, I mean. What have I just done? I'm going to go all the way through the colours. I've already colour coded this one. There we go. Looks better. You don't have to color code every single piece. If they're not going to connect, you don't need to color code them. All you have to do is to make sure that the ends are the same colors, otherwise it doesn't feed them out. Right, that looks good. Everything's separate there, so let's carry on. So the corner ones, I could, for example, I don't need to colour those. But I do need them to be the same colour. Either none or the same colour. Right. So that looks good. So we now have two sets. We also have a set of cables going around the back here, almost. Got to do this one as well. Get to the right place this time. Move that torch out of the way, put another one down below it. And let's drag the end power, the universal cables across. Now I need some more space. I haven't got enough space in here, have I? Alright, let's just quickly dig this away. I've still got a stone pack full, which are actually great for doing this sort of stuff. You'll notice here I've also got the obsidian pack full. But it's too fast. If I get the wrong angle, and make holes everywhere. But of course, that's also pretty good. Let's just finish it off with a stone pick. Ah, there was a little cave down there. Had some mobs spawning in here, so let's just fill that up. What have we got? Some cobblestone. When I was using the digital miner in this area, there were mob spawning because of the holes that I'd created in wherever the ores were. So just around here there were loads of little mobs, one or two. They weren't too dangerous, of course. Right, let's have a look. One torch there and one torch here. And that will be enough, and let's get this cable drawn all the way around. It's done from there. In fact, I only need to do this side now, don't I? One more. So these are all now connected. And I can still reach the underside of these. So Is everything looking good? I think so. So the next thing we're going to do is we want to get these things configured to be output. And that's another tricky step. So what I have to do here is I have to shift right click with the configurator on the very end piece. So the first time it goes to push, which is, and then the second time it goes to pull. Now there's nowhere for these things to go yet, so we'll just, what we'll do is we'll put down what I want to do in the first place. Now here is the space where I want to put everything. So I'm going to put a set of bins on the wall here. I haven't got them yet, but we'll get nine bins out of here. Have I got them in here? Yes, I've got 10. I want to leave one. The reason I need 9 is we've got apples. And let's start from here. Oh, that's the cable, isn't it? But you can do it here, in fact, can't we? If I put the bins and touch them on the top here, they should simply, and then strafe right, they should simply connect, which they are. Right, so there's 9 bins. Straight away, we're starting to get things in. So that must have been from where? So let's go around and check. That's coming from the one that I actually did configure. This one. Yes, I did. So the others aren't yet configured, so let's get undo those. Here. And you see they come in little blue containers. They're quite smart, actually. As long as that has an axe and goes in the right place, otherwise it'd end up in these. Oh, this one's wrong way around. Let's just rotate that. So I have to change the configurator to rotation mode. What did I just do then? How did that? Shift M. There we go. Let's rotate this one, and you have to be on the face that you want to rotate it to. There we go. Apples. Ah, okay. It's a bit weird. Something's really weird here. Never mind. We'll carry on. I'm sure they were the right way around to start with. So anyway, let's go now to this one here and shift right click that twice. I've changed the mode, haven't I? So I need it back to configurator items. Shift right click at the very top here. There we go. And that one's done. This is the oak chest here. The oak chest is a bit different because on top of the oak, I think it's the oak, we've got a chest. So all the items go into that chest. And the last one is here. There we go. Getting plenty of items coming into these bins now. And I'm sure that they are still up. There's something weird going on here. Let's just make sure this is configured in the right way. Rotate. Shift right click. Do I have to do it from the other side? Yes. So now you can see we've got jungle saplings, jungle wood, spruce wood, oak saplings, apples, birch wood, and spruce wood. So it doesn't really matter where they're coming into, to be honest with you. That's just turned around again. That's really strange. Anyway, never mind. We'll have to live with that one. Most peculiar. Right, the wooden one, the oak one, it's got a chest on top, so all the items are going into the chest. So let's remove that chest, and then the items will come out of here. Now, this chest will probably be full, and so is my inventory. So let's get rid of all of this before I can move the chest down through the little trap here. So So let's have a look. I'm not sure where they're going to, of course, because they've all turned around. No idea where they are. A bit inconvenient. Let's move up the. Just actually the spruce wood that didn't go in. Where does that go to then? Right, double right clicking. Have I got 8? Oh, look at that. Well, what is in these two? Jungle saplings and jungle wood. Have I got 8? I've got 8, that's the trouble. Okay. So I need to break this bin and pick it up. Good. So, let's put that one on the end here. And that should then get into it, the spruce saplings. Which in fact I can put in by itself. It should go in automatically. Here we go. Perfect. So now I can click that. So, that bit's done. So we're getting the output from this working fine. The next thing is to do the power. I have prepared some of this. So what we need to do first of all is we need a crusher. And here I've got an energized smelter. The idea is with the energized smelter is to make charcoal and with the crusher is to make biofuel. Now, to make the biofuel, we then need a biogenerator. And for that, we actually need the output from the crusher. So let's do that first of all. So let's put the crusher down and say, where am I going to put it? Somewhere near these pipes, I guess. Maybe here. Enrichment chamber, ha ha. That's the energized smelter. Okay, I want to put the energized smelter to the right of it, I guess. Doesn't really matter. Actually, it doesn't matter. Let's put it back where it was. Because on the top of these, I'm going to fill in this. So what we now need to do is I need some power for this. And I created an energy tablet for that. That's no problem. And in fact, I've got some saplings in here. And so we put the energy tablet in here and it fills up the power. And I can put one energy sapling in here, one sapling in here. Doesn't matter what type. And it will produce biofuel. There we go, two biofuel. Now I need the biofuel in order to make the next item. So we need basically these items in here and we want to make a biogenerator. So that's that recipe. So we needed the biofuel to make that. So there we have our biogenerator. What the biogenerator is going to do, and I think I have to put it down the other way. I thought so. Because I want the power coming out the back. Or I can rotate it with the configurator. Let's do that first of all. No, it was already in wrench mode. Rotate mode, there we go. So you just hit it on that side and then that becomes the output. So therefore I can now take the power down from the machine. See, that connects up. So that now gives power, would give power to there. Of course these other machines are also going to need power. So let's give them power as well. And put take out of here these two biofuels and put the biofuel into here. And as you can hear, it makes, it's generated some power, which will have gone into, well, that's gone into the crusher and the energized smelter. The next thing I need to do is to take from the top of this crusher, which will use a mechanic, a logistic pipe for the torch, won't help me at all. One slot here. I want to put that into here like that. Then I need to configure this so its output is from the top. So I click the side configuration here, and at the moment the output's from the top, so we need the output from the top like that. Now shift click those two because we don't need those from the bottom. It's a good place to put it on the bottom of the power, but in this case it doesn't matter. So also I think I need to configure this. Let's do a shift M again to get it to configure items. I think I need to yes, there you go. See, tells you where the output is there. Dark blue. We'll try anyway. Let's take some spruce saplings from here. Actually, oak would be best because I've got plenty of oak. Let's put those. Oh, I need to move that like that, of course. Let's put those into the crusher and wait a little bit to see if or not those items come out automatically. Ah, they won't do because I haven't set an auto eject. There we go. Auto eject goes into the biogenerator, produces fuel. Now, the next and last step of this process is to power these machines. Now, in here, I prepared some RF engine upgrades for the progressive automation. What you have to do is you come along here and you basically take out the fuel that's in there and put in its place this RF engine. And it, straight away, it's got one thing. And as soon as I did that, the connector connected. So I have to go around all of these machines here and do that on each one. And again, the power's connected and it's lit as well. You see, no connection. Put all of these in. Oops, missed that. Try again. It's got plenty of power in there, and as you see, items coming down quite nicely. Birchwood. I can't get past this. I think that's done. Have I done all four now? I think so. Yeah. I'm going to double check because you're never 100% certain. Yeah, it looks like everything is connected up. Yeah. So, that's most of it done. Now, the next thing I do is from. The good thing about this is I've done them at three high. So let's, for example, take our oak saplings out of here and put them in the end one. So I'm going to make some space because I've got none at the moment. Let's put... I don't need... No, maybe I do need the power cables, actually. Because, of course, I could then power these machines as well using power rather than pellets. So to do that, what would we do? We'd probably bring this cable across here. Let's do that. Where shall I connect it to? Let's have a think. Maybe this piece at the end is good to do that too. One more. Get to the actual space I want to be. So that's now connected to those, but of course those are not looking like they're connected at the moment because we haven't got the upgrades in. So let's get the upgrades in there. Now it connects. I do that same for every single one. So that's now powered. And we'll put some more cobblestone in there. Make sure that everything done. I didn't miss that one, didn't I? Right, good. So now, in here, I shall put all these pellets in place. We've got one extra RF. So what I want to do now is I want to get out of here I don't like this at all. I want to get out of here and put into here the saplings. So what we can do for that is, let's have a look, those aren't working too well. I'm going to do those underneath because I need this. I can either do it at the front or the back. I think underneath would be better, so let's just quickly do that. Shouldn't take too long. And we need to go underneath here. I'm not sure I can do that like that, but maybe. A bit stuck on this top one, aren't I? Let me see if I can get around here. Huh. Right, that one should be the only one I need to take out. So let's bring the cables down here. Put them in here first of all. And there. There, and then we can bring it up here. Not Ah, well done. Got that right. I'll tidy those up later on, and I'll just pick up anything I've dropped, which I can't get to, of course. Yes, I can. Right. So these are now connected up. And what I want to do now is I want to track a pipe underneath from here, like that. And I've got the right one. Logistic pipe. Good. That's connecting on here. So this one here is the energized smelter. I'm going to move it. Maybe not. Let's have a look. How can I do this? So what I want to do is to bring it into here. We'll do it at the front. The saplings. And the other one I want to bring into here, the wood. So if I put down on here this one. Now, of course, I'm going to do the same thing as I did last time here. So I'm going to color code these. So first of all, it can use the same colors, of course. Make sure we've got the right mode. Yes, I have. So I'm going to simply color code these as being dark green. If I can get to the right spot, it's a bit tricky. Let's do this on here. Can I get to there? It looks like it's getting, well, the right mode, but I'm in the wrong spot. And here we can do dark blue like that. As long as it's dark blue, it's fine. You can leave the middle ones like that, because that's not connecting to, yes it is. I'll have to try and get around the back here somehow and get the one I want, which is here. So I wanted this to be dark green. Now it doesn't connect. So now it's not connecting to either of these two machines. So I have to reconfigure these two machines. Try again. So on the side here, I want input. So that's the dark red. And items will now be coming in. And on this side here, I would like to have, on the front of this one, I'd like to have dark blue. I've set it to the top. Let's shift it. That's actually ejecting. That's right, yes. And red on the front. Now, of course, I've got the wrong items in these two bins. Not that you can see what I've got in. Let's get rid of this stuff in here. And let's take out what we've got in here. So that's jungle wood. And it turned around. Good. And let's put the jungle wood in here. And that's working just fine. And let's put the saplings into here. Now I've got everything right. The saplings will probably not come into here yet because I've got oak saplings in. So that looks like everything is working. Here I'm getting, of course, biofuel. And over a period of time that will build up. And here I should be getting charcoal. And I've got no place to put the charcoal yet, but we could do that easily enough. Let's take, let's empty this chest out. Break it. And of course it broke my pickaxe at the same time, which is Paxel, because it's now run out. And find a place to put this. We could put this on the top, of course, which would be then reasonably accessible. Let's put it on the top. And then configure this to being output on the top. Auto eject on. At the moment it's input, so we just change that like that and on. And of course we don't get rid of these two. So now we've got biofuel coming in here. Okay. Right, we'll have to color code the, I know, I don't have to do that. I just have to simply right click this until it becomes off, and then that's the job done. So everything's now connected up correctly. We've got in here a heat generator, which is turned around. Let me go and change the mode on this one. I need rotate. How did that turn around? So I want it the other way around. Is This is being very strange today. Oh, hold on a second. It's actually on the back. There we go. Shift right click on there. And I've got power cable coming down here that I do not need now. Oh, I do need it actually, because yes, that's right. I must connect this here. Otherwise it doesn't work. Even though I've taken it around the back for the other particular machines, I don't need it underneath this particular machine because, let's take that out of here first of all. Because it only comes out of the back. So it goes up there, powers those machines, and then goes along there. Well, I could do, actually could do it that way around, couldn't I? That might be better. So if I put that there and that there, then it'll connect up there, and then I can get rid of these from this side behind here, if I can get behind, which I can't. I've got to go the long way around. And yes, I don't need any of these in here, do I? So that's now connecting through there. That's a bit neater anyway. So now everything in the farm is automated, and we shall get a chest of charcoal in here and biofuel, which we don't need, because let's take that out of there. Put the biofuel into here. We'll have plenty of power, which of course they can then use to charge up other things. But these bins are behaving a bit badly. There's something else you can do with the bins. Let's just have a look at this. So it's the rotate mode still. Okay, you have to look at it. You can't see it, we're looking here now, what mode it's into. I want to configure items. If I shift right click a bin, it actually changes its mode to light it up, and I don't know what that means actually. I've not yet found out what this means in terms of the bins, but let's look. I would expect it to be a sort of a lock or a redstone signal. Right. That's it for this episode. Next episode, I'm definitely going to go and do some plastics, because I would like to build a new base in the desert. In fact, I've been preparing that, so I'll quickly show you what I've been preparing, even though it's night time and I don't really care because it's well lit up. And the worst that happens, I fight a few mobs, so let's just get my bow ready if I have to do that. I was using the digital miner as a terraforming machine, and I've been basically, I would like some sandstone and some sand, because I want to build a base in the desert, and I need to make this area a bit flatter. At the moment it's a bit too high, and if you just look over to this sort of big hill, well, it's now half a hill, I've basically put the digital miner on the top there and told it to mine. And I told it to mine from the level we are at the moment, which is 70, up to the top of the hill, which was 99. And then, of course, it just mines away happily until it's finished. So we can jump up here. And as you can see, it's mining quite happily down to the ground level, which I think is 70. We should be a bit higher here, and this should be 70, 71. Maybe it's 71 or something. I like this, mind you, I must admit, I like this bow. It gives me a lot of fun, especially on creepers, I hate them. And there we go. And as you can see, it's been set to a radius of 32. What's wrong with it now? It's torch. Oh, it's been mining torches. Funny looking torch, but there we are. Of course, it's night time, so it's got no power. But here we should have some bins filling up with stuff ready for the that's coming to daytime now, so it'll start working again. And you see I've already got one advanced bin full of sandstone, and this one's almost full of sandstone, and if it does get full of sandstone, which it looks like it's going to, I'm going to remove these two and put one of those into here, and then that will then reserve the slot. Let's take that out of there. In fact, it's out of here. Put this one into here. and then put the sand into here, because it'll have a lot of sand as well. So, and any of the stones can stay in the digital miner. Right, that's it. Until next time. Bye for now.